एचओडीचा पासवर्ड टाकायचा ना, हे पासवर्ड नाही टाकायचे तिकडे. वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर संकेत चरखा फ्रॉम सिंहगड इंस्टीट्यूट सावित्रीबाई फुले पुणे युनिव्हर्सिटी. द स्क्रीन इज विजिबल फॉर एवरीवन, आई हॅव शेअर्ड इट, जस्ट लेट मी नो क्विकली.
नो सर.
सर
Yes, right now it's visible.
So we have started with the chapter of Indian Companies Act 1956, in which we have seen what is the meaning, what is the definition of the terms company, and accordingly we have dealt with. A company means a incorporated association under the Companies Act 1956 or any previous law which is into existence. Salient features of company, that is incorporated association, separate legal entity, limited liability, perpetual succession, separate property, transferability of shares, common seal, capacity to sue and being sued, and separate management. Then we have seen different types of companies as to chartered, statutory, registered, limited, unlimited, guarantee, private, public, holding, subsidiary, government and non-government companies. Then we have seen the differentiation between public company and private limited company and certain privileges and exemptions of private limited company. Explanation of each and every individual type of company was also been dealt with, and we have understood what is a government and what is a foreign company. We have started with the concept of incorporation of companies, in which we have seen the steps for incorporation or steps for formation of company. Then we have also dealt with what is the term memorandum of association, what are the various contents or clauses that have been included in memorandum of association, and lastly, what is the articles of association. Then, what are the various contents of articles of association with respect to rights, duties, powers, authorities and liabilities of the respective directors, members, and who are the participants in articles of association. Now, have we done this alteration of articles, limitations and alteration? Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So alteration of articles, yes, it can be altered as and it is not binding on the members. So limitations, not exceed the power of memorandum. Now we are moving with the next part, that is prospectus. So prospectus is any document as it is described or issued as a prospectus and includes any notice, circular, advertisement or the other document inviting deposits from the public or for the subscription or purchase of any shares in or debentures of a body corporate, section 2, subsection 36. So as per the two section 2, subsection 36 of the Indian Companies Act 1956, in simple terms, what is mean by prospectus? If any of the company, if they want to go for a public subscription, that they want to raise the money from the general public, then for raising the money from the general public, you have to issue a proper document which has been properly prepared, which has been properly drafted, signed by the respective authority, that is the chairman and the managing director and the board of directors. It is properly filed with the ROC, that is Register of Companies, and a proper approval filing with the ROC has been undertaken, and then such document is called as a prospectus. Now, what a prospectus can be substituted? Prospectus can also be called as an, it can be just a form of a paper in which a notice can be given. It can be form of a circular. It can be part of an advertisement or any other document which is specifically mentioning that you are inviting the money from the general public. So, for example, you must have seen that in various newspapers, you get a notice of IPO, that is initial public offering. The entire full page, it has been covered, and accordingly, the advertisement is given with respect to the IPO, that is initial public offering, whenever the company is going for listing of their stocks on the stock exchanges. So that particular concept is called as a prospectus, or a particular circular, that is in case of newspapers or in case of magazines, brochures, pamphlets, you get a certain circular with respect to one pager, that is a A4 page or a A3 page is been provided, and in that particular page of entire information of the organization with respect to the subscription of the shares or purchase and sale of shares is been provided. Advertisement. Now, advertisement can be available in newspaper, that is in print media, or on online or digital media, or roadside media also. So a certain subscription or a certain IPO offers or IPO launches or a IPO advertisement can be seen on the hoardings and flexes also, that is at the roadside hoardings, wherever the particular location that you find out on that particular hoardings also advertisement can be given, or advertisement can be given in TV, that is television also. It can be given on radios also. It can be given on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn and so on. Other document, any other document that has been required for you. So accordingly, the prospectus can be issued for the people, for the people or the general public. Now, what do we mean by prospectus from a student perspective? Now, when you are approached to a college, what happened? As per the norms of the government, every student must be provided with a certain document which is called as a prospectus of a particular institute. So what is mentioned in prospectus, that what institute is all about, what is the fee structure, what is the course content and everything. So all these things have been mentioned in that particular prospectus, the departmental history, the company history, each and everything has been mentioned, and that particular document is given for the candidate or a particular person who is trying to invest. So when you read out this particular information, you take a certain decision that whether I want to invest in this organization or I don't want to invest in this organization, and accordingly your decision differs from purchasing and selling. So in the same way, prospectus gives the entire information about the organization. So what constitutes a prospectus? An invitation to public. So here what we have a certain consideration in terms of Indian Contract Act, that is offer and acceptance. So what is a prospectus? Prospectus is just an offer and it is not an contract itself. So it you may accept the offer, you may reject the offer, and it is just an invitation to public. So here in this case, a particular invitation is given to the general public, and if you feel that, if you are willing, if you are desiring that I want to participate or I want to constitute a part of in this particular organization, then you can go and avail that particular offer. And if you do not feel, then accordingly you do not have to approach that particular advertisement, or you can neglect that advertisement. Invitation be or by on behalf of the company. Now who can give this invitation? This invitation can be given by the company itself, or it can be given by the members of your company itself. So who are the members of the company? The chairman, managing director, board of directors, chartered accountant, company secretary, and so on. So these are the legal members or the authorized members of the organization, and accordingly they have a certain right for inviting the money from the general public. So either of these particular persons or all of these persons jointly together can sign a particular document, and accordingly the prospectus can be prepared or it can be drafted. Initially you call a prospectus has to be drafted because it is just a rough draft that has been prepared, and accordingly unless and until you file it with the ROC, the ROC, that is Register of Companies, give you a certain approval, the prospectus cannot be said as an authorized prospectus. So only in the initial stage it is called as a draft of a particular prospectus. Invitation must be subscribed, must be to subscribe or purchase. So here why this particular prospectus is given, it is specifically given by one company, that is a company or organization, to a general public just for a mere consideration to raise the money from the general public. So if you want to raise, or if you want to increase the, or if you want to subscribe the money from the general public, so in order to purchase the shares of the general public, that is the people must come to your organization, they must purchase your shares. For this consideration, you invite the money from the general public, and hence in this way, the invitation is given for subscription purpose. Must relate to shares or debentures or any other instrument. So here in this case, always a prospectus must be related to for purchasing or selling of either shares or debentures or any other instrument which has been dealt with the organization. Now these particular shares, now what are various different types of shares? A shares may be an equity share or preference share, debenture share we can, but there are different types of debentures also, redeemable, irredeemable, convertible, non-convertible, and so on. So whether which type of debenture, whether which type of shares you are dealing with, or any other instrument, that is whether it is an equity share or a preference share or debenture capital or loan capital, all the things must be mentioned very clearly, and for raising the money only a prospectus must be constituted. If any of these purpose is not been identified, then accordingly we cannot treat or we cannot call the prospectus as a legal or authorized prospectus. Judicial pronouncements, always the term judicial pronouncement deals with a certain consideration that all the rules, regulation, guidelines that have been provided by the law, everything must be fulfilled, everything must be satisfied, and then only the judicial, then only the action or activity can be undertaken. If it has been observed that there is no legality into object, or legality of object is a part of an absence concern, then accordingly you cannot treat a prospectus as a legal or a valid document. So a proper document must be prepared, a proper draft must be created, it must be signed by the respective authorities. Whenever the particular respective authorities signed on that particular document, it must be taken by the approval by the all of the board of directors. A copy of same must be filed with the ROC, and approval of the ROC must be undertaken. When the approval of the ROC has been taken, then you have to go for the public advertisement, and then we can say that all the judicial pronouncements have been undertaken and the compliances has been fulfilled or followed. Now another option you have, that is statement in lieu of prospectus. So what do we mean by statement in lieu of prospectus? Statement in lieu of prospectus is a particular document which specifically mentions about promoters are required to prepare a draft of a prospectus known as statement in lieu of prospectus. Now a prospectus is of a certain consideration wherein it is a document of at least 10, 20, 30, 40 or at maximum of 60 pages also. Now if you want to reduce down this particular consideration, that is if you don't want to issue a prospectus of 60 pages, then you can prepare a draft of a certain prospectus in only one or two pages. So a brief summary, a brief statements of a consideration of the prospectus part, wherein a short title means short commencement of all the business activities. It has been mentioned on a certain single paper, and when all these particular statements have been jot down, such statement is called as statement in lieu of prospectus. A copy of it must be filed with the ROC at least 3 days before any allotment of share has been made. So if it is very of an urgent nature, if you cannot print or if you cannot prepare a certain document of either 50 or 60 pages, and accordingly you feel that prospectus printing is not possible, issue of prospectus is not possible, then accordingly just one pager or two pager statement in lieu of prospectus can be prepared, and it can be filed with the ROC, that is Registrar of Companies, and approval can be taken accordingly. What is the due date for it? The due date for the filing of statement in lieu of prospectus is minimum or maximum of 3 days. So within 3 days, the approval from the ROC has to be undertaken, and after that only the allotment of shares or the subscription of shares activity can be undertaken. It contains similar particulars as are required for a prospectus. So all the content that have been required in prospectus has to be included in the statement of lieu of prospectus, but it is always in a part of a summarized category. Prospectus gives you a detailed information, whereas statement in lieu of prospectus will give you a very short and specific and brief information about the organization. No minimum subscription is required to be stated. So here in this case, you need not to mention about what is the amount of subscription that you are looking for, whether the subscription is for 10 lakhs, 1 crore, 2 crore, 50 crore, 100 crores, 1000 crore, and so on. So here, subscription amount need not to be mentioned. As and when it is required, the subscription can be undertaken, and there is no hard and fast rule or compulsion as to statement in lieu of prospectus that has to be undertaken. If the statement contains any misinformation or omission, the liability, civil and criminal, is same as case of prospectus, and a fine of rupees up to 10,000. So if it has been found out that in case of statement in lieu of prospectus, you have given any wrong information, then both the liability, that is either a liability of civil nature or either liability of the criminal nature, can be imprinted, and accordingly the person may be, or the particular organization can be charged with a fine costing rupees 10,000. So here in this case, the fine of up to rupees 10,000 can be charged to an individual or the board of directors or the chairman, whosoever is signing that particular authority. So all the information in this statement in lieu of prospectus or prospectus must be very clear, must be definite, must be specific, and always real and not illusory. Error of omission is, that is, by default you cannot say that I forgot to mention, I have missed this particular thing, we forgot to mention such activity, and so on. So no omission, no errors or certain consideration has been acquired, and accordingly hence a penalty fine can be imposed to the respective authorities. The process of issuing securities through a statement in lieu of prospectus is a kind of a private placement. Now here in this case, statement in lieu of prospectus is not, it need not to be given to all the people or the general public. Statement in lieu of prospectus can be given to the specific people also. That is, if you are looking for a certain subscription and certain subscription is given for a specific people only, that is either 5 people, 10 people, or at max 20 people, then accordingly we can say that a particular statement in lieu of prospectus is of a part of a certain constitution, wherein the private placement activity is being undertaken. Now, private placement activity in certain cases can be called as an legal activity, or in some cases it can be called as an illegal activity also. Why? Because private placement deals with a certain consideration wherein you are giving this particular information, you are giving this particular statement only to the interested people and not to the general people. So here in this case, what does that thing means? That in case of a prospectus also aims for the general public, and statement of prospectus means for a specific people. So here in this case, we have to identify what is the type and nature of document that you are preparing for, whether it is prospectus or whether it is statement lieu of prospectus. So if it is statement lieu of prospectus, then a private placement activity can be undertaken. But in case if it is a prospectus, then accordingly you cannot call it as a part of a private placement, and accordingly the information must be given to the general public and not the specific people. Now moving towards the next part, that is share capital. So in relation to a company is limited by share, it means share capital in terms of rupees divided into a specific number of shares for a fixed amount of each. The memorandum must state the amount of capital and its various divisions. So in case of your memorandum of association, we have seen a certain clause which is called as a capital clause. So in terms of the capital clause, every organization, every member of the company has to specifically mention, or the chairman and managing director, the board of directors, they have to declare or they have to disclose what is the total capital of the company. Total capital of the company means what is the liability of the organization. Now, in case of your preparation of your balance sheet, so whenever you are preparing balance sheet, on your left hand side, in the terms of liabilities, the first item that is applicable is the concept of share capital. So in this particular share capital, it means about in the total lifetime of the company, what amount will be raised by the organization, or what amount will be raised by the company. So entire amount, entire lifetime amount that will be raised by a certain organization or by that particular company is specifically mentioned in terms of share capital. Again, now the share capital is divided into five or six categories, namely called as nominal, authorized or registered capital, issued capital, subscribed capital, called up capital, uncalled capital and paid up capital. So here in this case, okay, do you need an example for this share capital? Or everyone knows it?
It's a re-example, please.
Okay, I need to start my camera. Wait a minute. Marker. Bifurcation of share capital, I'll explain you. Add this device. Is it visible for you, na? I have made it small because I need to draw. Can you see it? You can enlarge your screen. Or I'll make it red color or blue.
Yes, sir. It is visible.
Visible, yes. Camera. Perfect.
Yes, sir.
So this is your balance sheet I am drawing in the books, balance sheet of so-and-so company limited. In this way you have balance sheet. So balance sheet of so-and-so, on this side you have liabilities and on this